Okay, everyone, we're going to take a quick toe dip into Martin world right now, and we're going to read a little bit of a longer section from Dream Songs 2, where George talks about his furniture role. Because after all, boys and girls, they're all Bat Durston stories. The answer is simple. Motor cars or horses, tricorns or togas, ray guns or six shooters, none of it matters so long as people remain. Sometimes we get so busy drawing boundaries and making labels that we lost track of the truth. Casablanca put it most succinctly. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. William Faulkner said much the same thing while accepting the Nobel Prize for Literature, when he spoke of the old verities of truth and heart, the universal truths lacking which any story is ephemeral and doomed, love and honor and pity and pride and compassion and sacrifice, the human heart in conflict with itself, Faulkner said. Alone can make good writing because that's the only thing that's worth writing about. What we can make up all the definitions of science fiction and fantasy and horror we want. We can draw our boundaries and make our labels, but in the end, it's still the same old story. The one about the human heart in conflict with itself. The rest, my friends, is furniture. The house of fantasy is built of stone and wood and furnished in high medieval. Its people travel by horse and galley, fight with sword and spell and battle axe, communicate by palantir and raven, and break bread with elves and fight dragons. The house of science fiction is built of duralloy and plastic and furnished in faux furniture. Its people travel by starship and air car, fight with nukes, tailored gems, communicate by ansible and laser, and break protein bars with aliens. The house of horror is built of bone and cobwebs and furnished in ghastly gothic. Its people travel only by night, fight with anything that will kill messily, communicate in screams and shrieks instead of gibbers, and sip blood with vampires and werewolves. The furniture rule, I call it. Forget the definition. The furniture rules. This is definitely the most common thread that runs all across Martin world. This is why we can read something like The Glass Flower and go line by line and find all of the comparisons to Daenerys. This is why we can read something like The Skin Trade and take a look back at the Boltons and the Red Kings against the Starks and kind of get a feel for what's about to come up in the A Song of Ice and Fire story. This is why we can read Armageddon Rag and see a little bit what Bran's and Stannis's plot and arc is going towards in Ice and Fire. So I encourage you guys and ladies and everybody to get these Dream Songs books, make notes, use them wisely. They're a lot of fun to read, and then if you want, you can come join the reread section that I have going on, where we discuss, compare and contrast and expose what's a fire dragon and what's an ice dragon in Ice and Fire using George's work. So I hope you enjoyed this quick video. Just a little impromptu test to see if something like this is going to be worth me doing in the future. I'm thinking possibly maybe as I do the different rereads, or even if I go back and make new videos, just as a little header. I don't know. Let me know what you think. The next story I think I'm going to work on is another in the Corpse Handler series, which is George's best work ever, Meat House Man. but then I might do a compare-contrast with Blood of the Dragon and Dany's chapters in Game of Thrones, because Blood of the Dragon is that novella, you know, that sort of sets the tone for the rest of the story for her arc. And then what else? What other story can I do? I don't know. There's got a bunch of stories to do. Let me know what you guys think. Have a good night.